This is Comb Ridge, one of the more impressive monocline sort of structural features that makes a real interesting topographic barrier and obstacle here in southeastern Utah. The river down there is the San Juan River, which flows from town of Bluff to Mexican Hat and then eventually joins the Colorado River down to the west of here. We're looking north here. The mountains in the distance are the Abajo Mountains, and we're looking right along the trend or strike of this impressive fold. So as we look to the rocks to the west here, you can see that they're kind of flat lying. They're more or less horizontal. But right in here, we can see that there's fins of rock sticking up at an angle all throughout this part that the river's flowing through. And then as we head over towards the east, we can see off in the distance there that the rocks are more or less horizontal again. And so the story of these rocks is this is what we call a monocline. And this great flexure or bend or fold in these rocks formed during the Laramide Orogeny. So about 70 to 60 or so million years ago, the rocks here in the southwestern US were compressed in an east-west direction as a plate was slamming into the west coast of North America. And that caused this big pile of flat-lying sedimentary rocks. Most of the rocks in the Colorado Plateau region are flat-lying, stacked from oldest to youngest, bottom to top. And it caused these rocks to actually flex and bend and form these impressive folds that run 70 or so miles. I believe Comb Ridge is about 70 miles from north to south. So let me take you down to a little diagram that'll maybe explain this in a little bit more detail. So if we start here, we've got a sequence of rocks, Permian, Triassic, Jurassic, Cretaceous, oldest to youngest, more or less horizontal. But then during the, again, Laramide Orogeny, we have compression from east to west. So these rocks get squished and they actually form a fault at depth, or what we call a reverse fault. And that reverse fault, which doesn't continue to the surface, causes the rocks above it to bend. So this big pile of sedimentary rocks, layered sedimentary rocks, gets bent and draped into this impressive fold we call a monocline. Mono meaning one, because it has one inclined what we call ramp or limb to it. And then if we add the effects of erosion, this is kind of what we see today. So as we look to the west here, we'll see some of the older rocks, the Pennsylvanian and Permian rocks to the west. As we move to the east, those rocks dive down into the subsurface and we have these fins of Jurassic and Triassic rocks sitting above them. And that's exactly what we see in the distance here. As we look to the west in the canyon, we can see some gray and reddish rocks that are the older Pennsylvanian Permian rocks. And then down here in the foreground are these fins of reddish Triassic mudstones and sandstones. And then continuing on to the Wingate sandstone, this really impressive fin. This thing's actually tilted down and away from the view here. So just an impressive little area here, the Comb Ridge Monocline, one of several features of this type that we see in the Colorado Plateau region.